What if you lost your job tomorrow? What if you spent more than a year trying to find work, all to no avail? Hello, I'm Susan Kennedy. As the economy still struggles, it's likely you know someone who has been laid off, let go, and is searching for a job. We find out how extended compensation benefits impact those without a paycheck, and we talk with the state's head of workforce development to find out how line workers and MBAs alike can prepare to re-enter the workforce. Right now on Tempo Public Square.
Support for Tempo Public Square is provided by the members of PBS 39.
Welcome back to Tempo Public Square. Back in the 1930s, a pundit defined the difference between a recession and a depression this way. A recession's when your neighbor's out of work. A depression is when you're out of work. And with the state's unemployment rate nearing 9%, this current recession could seem quite depressing. So how do we cope? As Tempo Public Square's Grover Silcox explains, time's running out for thousands of out-of-work Pennsylvanians who've been relying on those unemployment compensation checks.
Phil Diaz spends time on household chores while waiting for the economic landscape to change.
There are days when you get down. You know, you think it's not going to end, but things could be a lot worse. But still, I want to be working, you know, just like a lot of other people.
Every day, Phil pores over the tools of his trade as a union sheet metal worker. He checks in with the union hall hoping for a job, but the well seems dry. Gone are the big jobs on Philly's towering skyscrapers and structures. Gone are the wages and sense of security. Since January, Phil has seen days melt into weeks, weeks into months, with no job in sight.
Work is not good right now. We're hearing all kinds of bad news from the hall. You know, you go down there and there's absolutely nothing, no movement.
Fortunately for Phil and other Americans laid off during this recession, unemployment compensation benefits provide a safety net. In Pennsylvania, these benefits replace approximately 50% of a person's weekly wage, with the average weekly benefit at about $320. Plus, there's an additional $25 from the federal stimulus program.
The maximum weekly benefit is $558, regardless of how much you may have been making a lot more than that in your previous job, but there is a maximum.
Of course, unemployment benefits run out. In Pennsylvania, people start with 26 weeks of benefits. Finding a job in this recession is tough because there are six applicants who vie for every job opportunity.
Right now, there are approximately 540,000 Pennsylvanians who are out of work in this recession, which is a significantly higher number than we've had in recent years.
On this day, Phil has reached his 26-week limit.
If I don't get an extension and I can't find a job somewhere, you know, doing anything, then I will. I'll be like millions of Americans, you know, falling behind.
To help folks like Phil, federal and state governments have extended benefits.
Initially, the unemployment insurance was 26 weeks. And then, of course, in the period since the recession has started, the federal government and the state of Pennsylvania have made available extended benefits. So currently, workers can expect up to 79 weeks of unemployment benefits.
But what happens when the extended benefits run out? Every week since mid-September, thousands of unemployed Pennsylvanians have exhausted their extensions.
This last extension occurred on August 4th, where we got an additional 7 weeks of unemployment insurance for folks who have lost a job.
So, should the federal government extend benefits again?
I certainly think they should extend it based on certain conditions, you know, as long as people are doing the things they need to do to find work. I know people that have families and have houses are certainly in jeopardy of currently losing their houses and everything.
Obviously, if the unemployment rate keeps rising over the next several months, 6 months, we're going to need to revisit whether to extend benefits again to help out those workers.
But how will spending all of these taxpayer dollars impact the economy? Well, it may help. According to one popular economic rule of thumb, every dollar spent in unemployment benefits generates about $1.43 in economic activity.
If you figure that we have paid out about $2 billion in federal benefits, we have generated close to $3.5 billion in economic activity right here in Pennsylvania.
The extensions give unemployed individuals time to find a job that matches their skill sets.
Overall, the economy will grow faster if we allow people time to find the job that best matches their skills.
However, many jobs won't come back. and many unemployed people are looking to retrain for high-growth industries.
The stimulus bill provided a lot of money for training and retraining. And also, earlier this summer, President Obama announced an initiative to encourage greater use of community colleges.
Phil may take advantage of the education benefits, but still, he misses the work that has sustained him and many members of his family for two generations.
My father was a sheet metal worker. A lot of his friends growing up, a friend of his got him into the trade. My brother's in the trade, I'm in the trade. I have a lot of family that are in these kind of jobs, you know. And you can't just walk away from something like that, especially something that's been so good.
Job loss means more than losing a weekly wage. It often means losing health care, pension, 401k, life insurance, house and home, and even a way of life. Unemployment benefits, however, help folks hold on to hope, perhaps the most critical benefit of all. For Tempo Public Square, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
Thanks so much, Grover, and that certainly helps put a face on unemployment compensation. Joining us now is Pennsylvania's Deputy Secretary of Workforce for Workforce Development, Fred Dietrich. Thanks so much for coming in today.
It's
from Harrisburg.
Great to be here. Thanks for inviting me.
So people like Phil are out of work, and they're taking in the government checks, and the checks might stop coming. What is your department doing to help Phil find a job?
Well, first of all, what we encourage people to do is, prior to the checks running out, is to get over to our career links. We have 67 in Pennsylvania, and these career links are the place where people can find a lot of help to seek out the jobs that are available, or, if necessary, to find opportunities for training for the jobs that we hope will become available in the future.
So when you say the training, would that be going back to college, doing a skill, and how much is the government paying for Phil, for instance, to be retrained into something entirely different than he's experiencing right now?
Well, the training could vary. It could be going back to school. It could be going back to a community college program. It could be going to a certificate program that is shorter than an associate's degree. It could be going to a private sector school that is offering a particular skill set. It could be an apprenticeship program. So there's a whole variety of training that could be available. The cost is really dependent upon the length and the intensity and the technology involved in the training. And basically, the government, the federal government, is the one picking up the cost for this. We get funded approximately $100 million a year in my department for training. Most of that money goes out to our local workforce investment boards, and they make the decision as to who gets the voucher for the training. The Recovery Act provided another approximately $100 million on top of that. So right now we have a fair amount of money available, although it is going fast, but there is a fair amount of money available for people interested in training. And the important thing is to get into the career link, figure out where your skill sets match up right now, figure out where the jobs are right now and what training you might be interested in, and make some decisions. And you should do that way before your benefits run out.
Now, we're talking about more than 20,000 people in Pennsylvania who are out of work. So the budget for that retraining, you're talking $100 million from the federal government in different chunks. What's your total budget?
Well, the total budget for training is approximately $250 million for the whole
mm-hmm.
year, and some of that, the Recovery Act money, is probably not going to be around after probably by the end of next year.
Right.
I think most of that will be gone, but there are a lot of training programs that are available that these people will cover, that this money will cover. And so it's not going to cover all 470,000 people that are out of work right now.
Right.
But a lot of those folks, I think, will be called back because of the economy coming back. And some of the folks that we hope will be trained will be able to go into the jobs where there is growth in healthcare, in some of the areas. The utilities are desperate for replacing some of their retired workers, for some of their linemen. There are jobs in terms of the educational institutions. A lot of the educational institutions still are employing lots of people because a lot of folks are going back to school. So
right.
There is hopefully a momentum that will build towards the future that will put more money into the economy. More people back to work, more people will be able to spend, and therefore we'll be able to put more people back to work. The forecasts are that this will not be happening soon, though. And so what we want to urge people to do is to take this time to get retrained. And in this case, if they can find the funding through the Career Link, mm-hmm. the best thing to do is to take a little bit longer term training so they can get a higher level skill so that when the economy comes back, they'll be better prepared.
So a couple things I want to reiterate for our viewers. We will have the Career Link website linked through our website on the show, so we'll have that for people at the end of the show, so it's easier to access those things.
Sure.
But what are you finding, Mr. Dietrich, that people are not doing? I mean, you can log on to the websites, you can go to the job fairs. We just had one recently here, 60 employers with thousands and thousands of people looking for jobs. What are the people not doing correctly that might be out of work right now?
Well, I think they're not starting soon enough. Mm-hmm. That's one thing. I think the other thing is that they need to network with others. I think that's really important. If the Career Link has a job club, mm-hmm. that's really important that they participate in that. I think also that they need to attend events where the business community is putting on sessions with regard to certain kinds of activities with regard to economic development. So if the Chamber of Commerce is putting on an event talking about healthcare and about healthcare jobs, if there's a job fair being put on by the Chamber, or if there's a session being developed that gives you the opportunity to get face-to-face with employers, that's really important. I think a lot of the folks that have been laid off maybe have not had the experience of being laid off before, and so therefore this whole networking part, this gathering of information, the persistence to keep coming back to the Career Link, because the first time in, you may just be able to get a sense of what's available, but all of the Recovery Act jobs that are being developed through the investment of the Recovery Act in Pennsylvania are going to be posted on our system. They're required to be posted. And so almost every day there's going to be a change in the number of jobs on that system. So it's important that you stay in touch with it.
Well, and you said something that's almost so simple that maybe people forget. It's the networking. If you've sent the resumes out and you've been to the career days, et cetera, you still need to pick up the phone, set up some coffee dates with people who might know someone who might know someone in the future. And you also mentioned that people in the future who are retiring from spots.
Absolutely.
So it might not be something available right now, but...
That's right.
Down the road.
And one of the things is to not just read the want ads in the paper, but to read the stories in the paper about what's coming. The whole challenge of the green jobs and the green economy, those jobs will be coming, but they may not be coming in exactly the way people predict. So there might be weatherization jobs. There might be solar panel jobs. Some of these jobs may not come immediately because some of the investments that were expected are rolling out slower than we had hoped for. If there's a climate change bill passed in Congress, that could lead to a tremendous amount of growth in green jobs, but it may not happen for a year or two. So the important thing is to understand that emerging set of jobs so that you are positioning your skills to be effective when they become available.
And I also think, would it be easy if you're struggling to make ends meet and you're getting that compensation check, is it easy for some people to just rely on that and say, oh, I don't want to go work at a real low-paying job because then I won't get that payment check? So is it hard to look for a job when you're getting some of the government money?
I guess it is. Certain individuals are proactive. A lot of folks, this may be the first time they've been on unemployment this long, and right. They may be terribly discouraged. And so they may feel like this is really going to be incredible, and all the bad news that they read about.
Right.
And I do think that if you go out there and you find the job that's much lower than what you were being paid before, that may not be the right decision to take that immediately, but to keep looking. On the other hand, everybody's circumstance is different. So some people might feel, you know, I've got to have something, right. Because when the benefits run out, I have to have some income coming into the family.
Well, and that one job could, again, lead to another. It's all about that networking.
That's true. If you find a company where the opportunity for getting in at a lower level and moving up is good, then maybe it is worth the chance to take that job at the lower salary.
Lots more to talk about, and we'll be back with you in a few more minutes. Mr. Dietrich, thanks so much. Up next, though, she's armed with an MBA and got a raise at work and inadvertently cleared the way for her own pink slip. We'll talk about her story coming up next. The growth in unemployment stretches from the grill at the burger joint to the office of the CEO. In tonight's My Story, we hear from Maureen O'Leary. She worked hard for her money in the corporate world, only to discover she'd cleared the way for her own pink slip.
My name's Maureen O'Leary, and this is my story. I was a marketing director for 10 years at a manufacturing facility that makes police and fire equipment. I was recently laid off July of 2009 due to the economic constraints, along with many other Americans. So I immediately applied for unemployment compensation as well as Cobra Healthcare for my son and I. But now what? So first of all, we put ourselves on a tight budget. At no surprise, by the time we pay for the mortgage, utilities, and so forth, the compensation goes quickly. Secondly, I set some new goals. One being that I decided to transition from the corporate treadmill to education. So I researched what it would take to get my teaching certificate. It would cost me $10,000, and I don't have the funding right now. So I decided to apply for continuing education classes at the local community college. They are offering free classes for the unemployed. But unfortunately, I was denied because I currently have a degree. So I'm, of course, going to stay positive and push forward, but I do have some real concerns. One being the unusual struggling marketplace. The unemployment rate is outrageous. 5 out of 10 people on my block are unemployed. So it's all around. And secondly is I'm 8 weeks into my 26 weeks of unemployment compensation. So while I'm very grateful, it is what fears that I have is the ending point. So if I do need an extension, I hope that that will be there. I am fortunate for two particular things. One is that my education is behind me. I have my bachelor's and MBA, so that will expand my options for sure. Secondly is, I did plan for a rainy day, and that has truly saved me. I've kept my debts in order. So while the times are challenging and rocky, I'm confident with faith and hope, and through my resources and planning, that a creative solution will prevail. My name's Maureen O'Leary, and that's my story.
Thanks, Maureen, for sharing your story. And now we welcome back Fred Diedrich, Deputy Secretary for Workforce Development. Thanks again for joining us. Maureen is a different kind of job hunter right now. She's the white-collar worker. How does her search differ from Phil's?
Well, it differs in some ways, obviously, because she has a different skill set. But unfortunately, in this recession, even folks with her level of skill, a master's degree, can sometimes not find work. This recession is very different than what recessions that we've had before, in that it really has affected pretty much white-collar as well as blue-collar jobs in a very significant way. So yes, I think she's doing the right thing. She's thinking about, well, let me find a profession like teaching where I can get a more, you know, predictability with regard to future employment. And again, she's doing the right thing by going back to community college and trying to get some of the credits in that way. Community colleges are a great place for people that don't have a lot of money to go back and begin to put together the courses that they need that will eventually get them a teaching certificate. And yes, I think at the same time, she has the option to continue to look for other possibilities that may emerge. People that have those kinds of skill sets can need to think about where else they can be applied to, so that maybe there's a nonprofit organization that has the need for someone who understands the business concepts that she has, or maybe there's a government position that in fact we've hired a significant number of new folks for our career links because of our Recovery Act, and we've added like 75 people across the state, and we're continuing to add others. So again, people with a skill set that they thought took them into the private sector may need to expand their search to include other areas like nonprofit or government, where that skill set might be very much welcomed.
And those of us with jobs, is there something that we can do to help more than just visiting with friends who are searching?
Well, I guess the important thing to do is to think about opportunities for where we can help people out in terms of their job search, thinking about networking, thinking about who might know of a job. And I guess also just, you know, trying to be, you know, engaging these folks in a discussion about what if, have you thought about this? That's really important, because I think that sometimes people need to speak with others who are currently working, who can help them think about all of the possibilities, all the vendors that we work with, all of the organizations, the nonprofits, different ways that you can network and find out about jobs that may be available. And also, you know, people in our Career Link are folks that have spent a lot of time thinking about pathways. We talked about this earlier, and that is that if you look at a job and you say, wow, that's really, you know, at a level of salary that's much below what I was making, and it's a skill set that really, I'm not sure I would even be challenged in that job. If it's connected to a future possibility, then it might be worth the investment of time and energy. The other thing that might be really important would be to go to an employer and say, listen, I'd like to volunteer. I'd like to volunteer to help. Nonprofits might especially appreciate that. And sometimes volunteers work into, you know, jobs that become available.
Well, then your skills and your personality and your go-gettedness, it comes out, right? And
absolutely.
In another way. And you're constantly advertising yourself and your skills in that form.
That's right. It's really important.
Meeting the people.
Sure. And again, I think that one of the things that we have been able to do in Pennsylvania since Governor Rendell came in was to really make sure that we understood industry much better. And so we've organized across the state about 75 industry partnerships. These partnerships bring together companies on a regular basis where they meet and discuss not only their current challenges but their future challenges. And so a lot of our workforce investment boards have been responsible for these partnerships, and they pass that information on to the Career Links.
Okay.
And it's in those partnerships that we find out about where the jobs are changing and what new jobs may be emerging. And so I think it's really important to stay in touch, get the newsletter from the local board, make sure that you find out about those partnerships, make sure that you, again, stay in touch with the staff at the Career Link.
Currently, unemployment in our state's hovering around 9%. What's a good number that you'd like to see it, say, a year from now? What's success?
Well, I guess we're at 8.6. I would certainly like to see it under 8 by next year. That would be great. Unfortunately, it as often happens in a recession, the economy and growth, GDP growth, occur first before the unemployment rate turns around. So I'm not so sure we won't get to 9 before we go back to 8.5.
And what's your guess on the timeline? I mean, these economists say that we really started this recession in December 07, technically.
Right.
Next year, 2 years, what's your
well,
guess?
Well, again, a lot of folks are saying it's going to be a slow growth recovery, a slow mm-hmm. employment growth recovery. So, you know, if I could predict the future, I guess I'd have another job in the private sector. But right now, my guess would be is that we will begin to see some much better growth numbers in employment at the spring of next year, the spring of 2010. A lot of the Recovery Act money will be fully out into the system by then. I hope most of it will be out in spending. I think there will be, again, to be a some inventories will have to be put back. I noticed in the paper today that GM is calling back some workers in Michigan and the Midwest because of the Cash for Clunkers program. I think people are eventually going to have to, you know, begin to buy more materials. If the housing industry comes back, that would be an enormous boost to the economy.
And we're coming up on the deadline for that $8,000 real estate tax credit. So
that's
hopefully
right.
Some of those houses will get closed and then push everyone into the next home.
Absolutely.
Get that moving along. Just a little recap, because I found it a little confusing. We have the state compensation, normal benefits, then there was the federal extension, then we had another extension, and then just this week we're talking about possibly another 13-week extension. Does somebody really get all of that? It adds up to 93 weeks.
Some people get 79 weeks right now.
Okay.
Yes, absolutely. Now, of course, there's a whole variety of timing involved, mm-hmm. and I would not want to spend too much time explaining that.
Right.
That's not my particular area of expertise. But yes, some people have get that many weeks, and I think The extension, this 13-week extension, is incredibly important. We have, like we said, 23,000 people hitting the deadline next week that'll go off, and many of those folks would qualify for an additional 13 weeks, and that would be tremendous. As Secretary Beatty said in the earlier segment on the program, there is a tremendous boost to the economy by the issuance of the unemployment. One of the reasons I think that Pennsylvania's unemployment rate is lower than a lot of other states and much lower than the national average is because we pay, you know, a fairly decent unemployment average, about $320 a week, and that gets into the economy and keeps other people employed.
It keeps it all rolling along.
That's right.
Thanks so much for the status check, the update, and all the great suggestions.
It's great to be here, Susan. Thank you.
Fred Dietrich, coming in from Harrisburg today, much appreciated. Workforce Development Deputy Secretary for the Department of Labor and Industry. Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
All right, if you want more information about compensation benefits or programs to help you prepare to reenter the workforce, do check us out online at WLVT.org. Click on Tempo Public Square and this show on unemployment, and there you will find the link that Mr. Dietrich has been talking about to some of the state and local agencies that can help point you in the right direction on your job hunt. All righty, next time on Tempo Public Square, put down that cell phone and drive already. Are you chatting, texting, and Twittering your way through the city streets? Should you be allowed to, or should it be against the law? We'll talk about that next time on Tempo Public Square.
Support for Tempo Public Square is provided by the members of PBS 39.